have no need of a hole.
You will soon have need of a woman. You have not killed me, Lord, because that will leave you cursed still. Until the end and beyond. Our parts are entwined. And our fate is shared. He's here.
From Providence, Rhode Island, welcome to The Last Kingdom with Marian Blake. It's a podcast dedicated to the show The Last Kingdom on Netflix. So sit back, relax, and let's see how England was made. Welcome back. My name is Mary Larson.
My name's Blake. And, you know, technically, Mary, it's how England is born, not made.
I think I've been saying made a few episodes.
I think so, too. It's, you know what?
It's the remix. Okay. What?
Remix, whatever. Sure, no problem. You know, I just got to keep the branding right. You know, let's get that right now.
Potato, patata. Yeah. Stats are for nerds.
Fair enough. You know what? How dare you use my own spells against me, Potter? How dare you?
You're a wizard, Harry.
Oh, goodness gracious. Welcome to season 3 of The Last Kingdom.
We're here. We're here for it.
We're ready to go.
Got some new haircuts. Back to school haircuts.
And love the back to school haircut.
I do too. So fresh.
I am in on it.
The mohawk braid.
Yeah. So cool.
Little ponytail, but like capped off.
Like much better than all just one
Citric
flock of hair.
Citric is like the kid that, you know, had the growth spurt, had the new haircut. You don't even recognize it's him. I asked Blake, I said, was he recast?
Who's this guy?
Who is that guy, like, hanging out with the wife, rando?
Even Finnan. Finnan's got some new hair with this one, too.
He keeps it classy.
He keeps it nice and tight, yep. Good fade. Yep. We're ready to go.
I'm here for it.
We're here for the for the faded Finnan. So yeah, that is that. I'm excited by this, Mary. Yeah, because this is the first season that Netflix was at the helm for The Last Kingdom. So I look forward to seeing what the differences are between seasons 1 and 2 and now 3, and then obviously soon to be 4 and 5.
Okay.
You know, whether it is production value or storytelling, what kind of input did Netflix have? Is it going to be visible? Is it going to be something that stands out in comparison to the previous seasons? So it's going to be an interesting...
We will find out.
It's going to be an interesting dichotomy to see what we get into. So, that's it. That's all
okay,
I got.
Okay, well, for those of you who have not watched this episode in a very long time...
Whoa, wait. You're messing the whole process up.
I don't even have the Google Doc up.
You don't even have the Google. We got a whole outline.
We've been off. For those of you who are listening to this in the future, hello, how's the weather? What's it like there? but for those of you who've been watching and listening currently, we've had to take a little hiatus as I had surgery last week, and it's been a little rougher of a recoupment than I would like to admit. So yeah, I'm a little out of practice. I don't even have my Google Doc up.
Well,
I guess
then
I'll get that.
I'll take it for you. Just wanted to remind you guys, of course, that you can subscribe to this podcast if you're not already. Please do so on any podcatcher of your choice. And if you want to talk to Mary and I, you can just search us on the social media platforms as Mary and Blake, including, yes, even TikTok, despite it ruining America. And of course, go to jointhenerdclan.com to become an official Nerd Clan member, where you get all a whole bunch of great stuff and extra bonuses from Mary and I, including our world famous knee jerk reactions, which we just put one up to for No Time to Die, the new James Bond film, as well as the new Halloween film, Halloween Kills. Mary, were you a fan of Halloween Kills?
No, I thought it was lame.
Actually, you know what? I did too. I need to read all about it. Jointhenerdclan.com. Marvin, are you ready to get into the show?
Yes, I am.
Let's do it.
So So the quick little recap, as I said, if you haven't most recently watched this episode, the season premiere of season 3, just to recap it for you, King Alfred, wicked sick, not going to be here very long, won't even last through the summer, I believe. And there's some new bad guys in town. It's this guy Bloodhair and his sorceress Skade, who is gross.
Yeah.
Goodbye. Can't wait for you to die.
Goodbye.
All set with that broad.
All set. All right. Of course, I want to let you know, obviously, of course, that this is episode 1, as Mary just said. It was directed
That's what I said, booby trap.
I know, I gotcha. It was directed by Eric Leyenborg. You know what? I would tell you what movies and films he's done, but I didn't recognize a single one of them. So, you know, do that on your own time. Go to his IMDb page if you'd like and look at all the different stuff that he has done. This one was written, once again, by the showrunner for The Last Kingdom, Stephen Bouchard. Marvin, your Shields rating, what are you giving this premiere episode 301, Last Kingdom?
A 4.
Wow.
I want to give it a 3.
What? Whoa. All right. You know what? I know you don't normally get into the thought process until the GBG.
We'll get there, Blake. You just hang on tight. What's your Shields rating?
The listener, if you're watching or if you're listening, you think like this is fake. No, this is real. This is legit. I am at a loss for words at this rating.
This might be nice.
Wow. Holy smokes. Okay. Here we go. We're going to have a good episode today. My Shields rating, I'm going to give it a 4.6.
Okay.
Once again, rarely higher than Mary. Hmm.
Just throwing a new lady with lots of eyeliner and you're good to go.
You know what?
Oh, she's a sorceress? Okay, yeah.
You're going to be surprised, actually, Mary. You're going to be surprised. I'm not going to lie. All right, fine. Let's get into it. You gave it a 4. You want to give it a 3, which is fine.
Thank you.
What do you...
Had I not already watched seasons 1 and 2 and like cared about some of these people slightly, it would have gotten a 3.
Okay. All right, so... All right, let's do it then. Your GBG. What do you have for your GBG?
My good is that I'm happy to see the clans all here, the groups all here. Okay, Alfred, great job acting still.
Yep.
I'm happy everyone's home. It's like old home week a little bit, okay? Even Tora shows up. I don't know what Tora was doing. Like, you're not one of the servants, and she's just like, hi, I'm just here to say a little something awkwardly. Is it my acting, or is it just Tora? I don't know. My bad. I'm going to have, like, a million bads. Everything to do with Skade. Everything.
Okay.
Period. If she was in it, if it was being said about her, whatevs, get out of here. I hate you. Hate you. It's, like, worse. Not even bad. Worst.
What? All right. Can you tell me why?
First off, she's gross. Like, okay, cut it enough. Out. Fair cut enough. Cutting out things, period. Okay? Cut it out, meaning don't cut out hearts or eyeballs or whatever you cut off that poor guy because I assumed it was his real balls. I don't care. Like, stop it. You're gross. Drinking your blood and then making out, you're gross.
Yep, sure.
You're a floozy. You want to sleep with me? Would you like to sleep with me? Would you like to sleep with me? You're a terrible like person who can tell the future. You didn't see that your boyfriend was going to drop you like a hot potato. Peace out. Terrible sorceress, okay? Plus, then Uhtred like threatens to rape her. I'm sorry. It's 2021, Uhtred. You've just gone down many pegs on my leg.
Well,
goodbye. No, there's no well. I don't care that it was in the time frame. Okay, we hold people accountable with how much rape there is in Outlander, and we'll say like, oh, it happened, but it still sucks. The fact that Uhtred, who was supposed to be my freaking Gryffindor, threatens a female that she's going to be raped by an entire town, all set with you, Uhtred. Bad influence, Skade. Okay. I don't even have a great.
Well, let me...
You know what my great is? What? I'm glad that Ethelfred showed up and she's like queen of the castle.
You know what your great was? The credits.
Yes.
No, I...
Ethelfled, whatever. Princess, you're my great. Cheers to you.
Yeah, sure.
Sure. The end. How about what you were through GBG?
Let me just say one thing. Do you honestly... We take Outlander to task and other shows to task when it actually happens. Do you really believe that Uhtred would have done what he threatened?
The only reason I think he wouldn't is because he's afraid she'd curse him.
Well, he already is cursed. That's it. Forget about it. So I guess what I'm getting at is I understand your reluctance about that whole thing. And my thought is I don't number one, believe that Uhtred would do it. Number two, you also have to understand who he's talking to. That is a big deal towards Bloodhair. Okay, that's a huge deal.
I just think it took Uhtred's class level down. Not classy, Uhtred. You got a nice haircut, thought you classed it up a bit. You could settle down, had a nice wife.
Yeah.
She probably died because he said that.
You know what? Oh, hold on. This deserves it.
Shame.
100%. Where's that bell? Because that is what I'm tying around Uhtred's neck for a couple of episodes.
Yeah, fair enough. All right.
Not enough Bjarke, not enough Hild. My bad list can go on and on, okay?
Well, we'll get into the rest of the bads for you when it comes to this episode, when we get into the analysis. My good, though.
I'm really glad you actually liked this episode.
I did. I did. There are some things that I did not like, but you know, it is what it is.
Spending so much time with hashtag who are they?
Well, no, I mean.
I'm all set with a new bad guy in town, okay? It's like a new flavor of the week. New woman, new bad guy.
Yeah, I got some ideas on this, and I got a couple of theories.
Okay, what's your GBG? I'll let you land the plane.
And by the way, for those of you watching us, you get a chance to see my incredible Patriots Christmas sweater that I'm wearing.
Because
the
holiday season is here. I believe the holidays start at Labor Day.
Yeah, sure. And my kids got me this, so I want them to look back one day and say that Dad actually wore this in front of thousands of people. And you know what? It's awesome. So if you get a chance,
awesome.
And it's the ugliest thing I've ever seen. But it's amazing, and it's really soft,
uglier.
And it's nice.
I've seen uglier.
So if you get a chance, go to the YouTube or the Facebook or whatever, and check out my awesome outfit right now. I can't get any more Boston than what I am right now.
Your cousin from Boston.
Okay, so my good. I can't believe you didn't have a great. That's unbelievable.
I said Ethelflaed.
Oh, okay, all right. My good is the first the snow that started falling. I know you do. When they were leaving Esheringham, I thought that was
where's Esheringham?
That's in Wessex.
Yeah, exactly. Continue. Where's Esheringham?
Esheringham.
Whatever.
It's where they all met.
Who met who? No pronouns.
Uhtred and Alfred meet up, and they have to go fight Bloodhair at the hill.
It's where Alfred threw up.
No, that was in.
It's where he went to after he threw up, and he's like, "Why am I here?"
And Aelsweth just walked right in his puke. If you notice that when he leaves, when they're in Winchester, right?
Who's Aelsweth?
Aelsweth is his wife. Remember when Alfred gets up, he pukes, and then he walks. He's like, "Yeah, I'm going to take some air." Yeah. Aelsweth gets up and just walks right in the path of the puke.
Yeah, where's cleanup on aisle 9? You got so many servants. Let's do this.
All right. So the snow leaving Esheringham, I thought that was great. Whether or not that was real snow or planned snow, that's something that you just don't see all that often.
You're in the holiday feel as well.
I am. And
when they're on the horses.
They're on the horses, and they're trying to get away. And
that was real snow.
That was real snow. Okay.
Yeah.
I think.
Do you like that? I can tell when things are real snow or not.
Because you are a snow expert.
Yes.
It's just one of those. I think those fortunes that you get when you're in that environment, and it adds to the production value and the reality of what that world is. It's a small detail, but when you get a chance to see it, it just adds to the texture of. Like the breath coming out of their mouths. Mm. And it's just, I loved watching how that all went
authentic.
Down. Also, tied with the snow is the shot of Bloodhair raiding the town.
All set with Bloodhair.
And there's the shot of him, and he's like looking out, and he's in front of this burning house, and there's like smoke and fire. And I just thought that shot was a really, really great shot.
Okay.
For what they're trying to tell. And I'm not saying it's an immediate point of Netflix's influence or budget, mm-hmm. but it is it is indicative of a more detailed, powerful shot than we've been getting, I think, of recent time. My bad for me is, like you, Mary, Skade. I'm kind of out on Skade.
You know, she's the new Sven. She's Itty Shea Skade.
Itty Shea Skade.
All set.
I'm going to give it to you because first off, we have her, you know, have the vision. The vision was cool how that was shot. It was like fiery red.
I'm actually excited that Alfred's going to die in battle and not in bed.
You think he's going to die in battle?
Wasn't that her vision?
Well, that is her vision.
That he gets struck down?
Yes.
I would love that for him.
I would like that too.
You know, but rather than like baking bread, being like, I should probably nail this before I die.
He would burn the bread. We all know that. Yeah. It's already been said and done when he was on the lamb in the marshlands. you know, the vision was cool, how it was shot. It was
Agreed.
Like, it was almost like monochromatic. Yeah. Really, really great shots. But what I didn't like was that stupid scream after the vision. I'm like, what
her,
are we?
Her screaming.
Yeah. Like her screaming up and the
yelling.
Camera pulls up and yeah, and like.
And you're like, who is this person? What an aggressive, abrasive
it's like
opening.
Way too much.
To a season opener with someone I don't even know.
Yeah.
Like, it's not
who,
even someone I know.
Who are you?
It's not even like it's Finnan having a bad dream and you're like, oh, it's okay. No. Get out of here.
It's just way too much. And then like, I don't mind the fact that she has this thing where guys can't look at her.
I
like that too. And I even like the fact that she pokes the guy's eyes
I'm
out
okay with that
and
too.
Does the tongue thing. But then she goes into the town. She's still yipping yapping about you can't look at me and only the
oh
women.
My gosh.
And that.
She reminded me of the annoying woman from Squid Game.
Oh.
You want to be my boyfriend? Huh? I'm going to get you. I'm going to cut you. I was like, oh, I've already seen this woman, but South Korean.
Oh,
annoying.
Oh, man.
Annoying.
Annoying. I'm kind of out on Skade and how she's yelling and she's like
Squid Game
taking
Skade.
Out hots. And it's cheesy and it is overly comic. Like it is overly.
It wasn't scary and there was no depth to her darkness. She was annoying.
Yes. And I think if they lean into the darkness a little bit more, I'm going to be better about it.
She could have done that with the priest. I think if she hadn't been just complaining and whining all the time, I loved how she was like, no, these priests serve my purpose.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm going to like cut and use different things out of them.
Yeah.
Even
okay,
though
what
I
is
don't
the
like
purpose?
Her.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like,
yes.
At least there's a reasoning to it. And then she
just like breaks the heart. Like
the other thing I was confused. Well, not confused. I just didn't like it. And she's like, where's the silver? Where? If you don't tell me where the silver is. Like,
she needs a mute button.
You know, that kind of person, I don't.
I wish it was Squid Game so I could just close caption her.
I didn't buy her at all. And that was, I think that's going to be a major issue with season
three. An actress.
As an actress and as a character.
Yes.
The whole thing.
Yes.
I just didn't buy it. But my great, and I, this is.
I'm so glad you hate Skade.
I'm out on Skade.
So happy.
I'm out. Immediately out. My great, though, it has to go to Alexander Draymond. I'm warming up to him. I think it's his delivery that I don't like.
Is that Uhtred?
Yeah, Uhtred.
You just like his haircut.
I love his haircut.
It's so good. It's my favorite one so far.
I kind of want that haircut. If I didn't look stupid, I would have that haircut.
You have such fine hair that I think it would braid and it would just kind of stick up like alfalfa.
Yeah. That's true. I'm warming up to Alexander Draymond, and especially at the end when hashtag spoilers, Gisela dies.
It's not hashtag. Spoiler. We're all here.
That was a really beautifully acted scene when he's like, I have to go to her. And, you know, the whole thing with Hild.
I agree.
I'm really liking him.
As an actor.
I'm growing on him more. Again, like I said, I think it's the way he delivers, like his intonation. It's kind of awkward sometimes.
Hmm.
But
he's very believable. We're here. We believe this is Uhtred.
Yes, absolutely. I buy Uhtred. In the same way I don't buy Skade,
yes.
I buy Uhtred.
Yes.
And that's that.
Okay.
All right. So what do you got What else? I mean,
I don't even think we need to hate on Skate anymore. I mean, just the jury's not even out. It's not, is the jury out meaning they're confused? The jury's out in Skate? No, the jury has put their verdict in. She sucks.
I don't know if I can say she sucks.
We just called her Itty Shay, whatever.
Itty Shay Skate. We did.
But okay, the only scene that I liked
what
is with her and Alfred.
Loved that scene.
And I think that's because I love Alfred. I don't love Alfred. I like Alfred's character. I like seeing his journey. I like seeing him break down. Like, here's a guy. Here's what's really cool about Alfred's scene with her. This is a guy who is in charge of the church. This is in charge of Christianity and is in charge of this idea that, like, we live these lives and we try to be good and we try to be Christians and we get to go to heaven. And it's really interesting to see the parallel between how he acts, hearing that he's going to be dying really soon, and him being like, oh man, mm-hmm. I really like summer. I'm sad. I'm going to miss summer. Yeah. The mortality of it, plus the mortality of the priests when the one that's hanging that's saying, okay, Lord, like, I'm totally cool with dying. I'm pumped to go to heaven, but I'm not excited about the journey to get there. I'm not actually excited about the dying process, being killed.
Right.
And so it was neat to see these two men of deep faith and to have him have that conversation with Itty Shay
Skade.
For Alfred, who has been so strong and not leaning into the pagan stuff, like even making fun of pagan houses.
Yeah, but you know, Alfred has shown a history here of using pagan knowledge and influence.
Saving Edward's life.
I mean, saving Edward's life. I mean, when it came down to it, he was about the Iseult life, okay? And by the way, uses Uhtred as a pagan to fulfill all of his desires. As they say in this episode, Uhtred is a kingmaker. And Alfred knows that, which is why he's making sure that Uhtred trains Edward as much as he can.
Yes.
So Alfred is a character that is full of contradictions. And Mary, you are absolutely right. That is what makes Alfred a great character. It's not that he's just 100% plain, oh, God's great, yay. He has that on the surface. But down below, he's willing and capable and wanting to do anything to make England the way that he wants it, mm-hmm. but also find out about himself mm-hmm. and using that scene as a baseline for his toe dip into paganism is really important. The other scene I think I found interesting with Skade, though jarring, is when she is on the wall and she's screaming out for blood here and this and that. Oh, come get me, avenge me. There's a king here, yada, yada. And they do the whole thing and everyone's asking Uhtred, can you please just shut her up? Can I slit her throat? What are you doing? And then all of a sudden it stops. And then Uhtred's looking out over the wall. And then Skade is quiet, looks at Uhtred and is like, she just whispers. Oh, Uhtred, you know, you and I can rule the world, blah, 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 blah. Like,
yeah,
that kind of comes out of nowhere. But I find it interesting. What were your thoughts on this?
Oh, girlfriend just wants to stay alive. She knows the drill.
Yeah, but she's not saying it specifically to Uhtred. She's like whispering it to her own self.
No, she was looking at him.
Well, yeah, but...
And he was underneath the archway, so I think she knew kind of the physics of sound and like how it was going to carry in the archway right to him.
Sure, sure. She put a compressor on. She knew that the archway mm-hmm, was a compressor mm-hmm. and that it would go through. Yeah, I understand it. Yeah. I find it interesting because now we know that Gisela is dead. Which, by the way, pour one out for Gisela.
Oh, man, right?
Not happy about this development.
She was like, this was going to be my last one.
Yeah, like, I'm done. We're done. You're going to sleep on the couch for a time. When you come back.
Yes.
And then everything's going to be fine again. I can't say I knew that it was coming because I didn't think that they would kill her this early in the season.
She just doesn't serve a purpose anymore. You know, we're not here for their romance. This is an Outlander. She's no Claire Fraser. She isn't. She's wonderful. She's nice. She's no Claire Fraser, Blake. She is not.
I think that's...
Oh, I'd like you to say that to Katrina Bow's face next time you see her.
That's true. Fair enough. All right. I will see that point.
She was nice.
Too. She was nice.
She was great.
I liked her for Uhtred. You want to know why?
Agreed.
I like her for the same reason why I love you for me. Because you ground me.
Yes.
And you take care of me. And when I'm doing something stupid, for the most part, you call me out on it.
Yeah, I agree.
And you're my opposite. And Gisela is the opposite. Like, she knows when things ain't right, you got to move on.
Mm-hmm.
And Uhtred is just too... Or at least he has been too arrogant, or he has been too confident to know his limitations.
She reminds me of Eliza. You know, look around.
Oh,
like,
oh, yeah.
We're so lucky. Can we stop being in wars?
Yep.
Can we just go take the quiet life?
Yep.
You know? And there's Uhtred, Alexander Hamilton, working nonstop.
I'm sad for Gisela. I liked that character. I like what she brought. But it does open up an avenue here for Skade. So, I mean, Mary...
Would you call it avenue? Or do you just think that Uhtred's going to need somebody new in his bed?
Yes, I do. And I have a question for you.
Yep.
Is it going to be Skade? Or is it going to be Aethelflaed?
I think he'll be partially seduced by Skade. I don't know if he's going to actually... go all the way.
They're going to have the rumpy pumpy.
But I think she's going to show a little nip. She might do a little petting, maybe a little earlobe nibble or something. Like, there's definitely going to be something.
Yes.
Probably boobs. Maybe butt. Okay. Maybe some butt stuff. Like, she might not like anal. But I mean, like, she might take her dress off when we see her bum. And then she might turn around and it will be like, no, hey, Uhtred. Sorry.
You know what, Mary? Bam!
Just like that. A winner! Listen, I'm trying to make Skade more interesting because she sucks. No, but I think she's there. She's let it be known that she's DTF with Uhtred. Uhtred, I think, may imbibe in some bevies and make poor choices.
Yes.
I think that Uhtred is not perfect. Uhtred, as I said, he did something in this episode that brought my opinion of him down a little bit. I would not be surprised if Uhtred fools around with her. I just wouldn't be surprised.
Fair enough. I have a theory about all of this. My theory about this episode is due in part, I think, to Netflix. Because I think this season is going to go one way or the other. Okay? What I mean is this. This episode was just very familiar. It's just the same thing. Like,
your new bad guy.
You got the new bad guy with the creepy sorceress. They get into
Shield wall.
They get into a big battle. Shield wall.
Alfred's sick.
Ethelwald is Ethelwald. You know, and then
Uhtred's,
we have
Uhtred's honey dies.
Uhtred's girlfriend dies. Like, it's just this. It's more of the same.
I think that's why I rated it so low.
And you know what? That is a fair criticism for this particular episode.
Yeah,
the reason why. Yeah, you're right. It's not that it's bad. I'm just bored. Like, the show has to continue to push the envelope in order for it to be what I want it to be. And this, it's like a nice pair of old boots. You know what? Like, when you get in those old boots, are they nice? Like an old pair of Uggs. You get in the Uggs.
I don't really like an old pair of Uggs. I like to get a new one every season.
Feels good on the foot.
Kind of like lose the shape.
Well, you
smell a little.
You know how like the sole molds to your foot.
Yeah,
a little
I don't
bit,
like
the
that.
Archway?
I want to have it nice and new and fluffy. I don't really know where you're going with that.
What I'm trying to say is, those old boots, they serve you well. They've gotten you places. They've gotten you to where you've been.
How about jeans?
Jeans, great.
Okay,
great.
Now we can talk.
Okay, you got those. You got that. You know what I'm talking. That
the pair of jeans.
That pair of jeans. Okay. That whatever pair of jeans you got, it's that one.
That's the good one.
That's the good one. And it's gotten you places. You go out and it can dress you up. You can dress it down. You can go out to a pub.
No muffin top. Just long enough.
It looks great in heels, but it also looks good with some chucks. It's just a good pair of jeans and you've been wearing it forever. But it's not the sexy jean. That's the problem. The problem that we have here is that we're in the old jeans. We need the sexy jean.
I thought this was sweatpants.
Sure.
Hey, I thought, all right. I know it was like watching a Hallmark Christmas movie. I know the plot. I know how I'm going to feel at the end. I'm bored.
So here's my theory on this.
It's not my favorite pair of jeans. This episode was not my favorite pair
of jeans. No, it's just a well-worn pair of jeans that you rely on that you know is going to look good, but it ain't going to stand out.
I disagree. I think it's a cheap Walmart knockoff.
So here's my theory. Netflix knows this. Like, either they made an investment in this show to give the viewers what they want, what they've been liking up until this entire time, or they're going to get weird with it.
Okay.
And I hope they get weird with it because I love
weird. What do you mean by weird?
I don't know. Maybe.
Aliens?
Not aliens. This isn't The Leftovers. That was Mary's big theory for four years was aliens. No.
They're not aliens, by the way, in The Leftovers.
We're not spoiling it. It's not even close to aliens.
No.
Either they lean into, in order to legitimize how
boring.
No.
Predictable?
No. How off-kilter Skade is.
Oh.
Like how cartoonish she is, they're going to have to legitimize it. They're going to have to give her some weight, like, to the narrative.
She's no Isolde. Not yet.
No, definitely no Isolde. Definitely not. But they're going to have to lean into her curse.
They need to lean into the fact that Uhtred thinks she's of great value. Is she just a great value because she's a prisoner, or is she of great value? Is she of great value because of her sorcerer abilities? And if so, I need to see some bibbity boppity boo.
And that's why I'm saying, in order to legitimize that cartoonishness, they have to give Skade some real heft in terms of the narrative for her to be like an actual character. And not just a cartoonish, like, Viking sorceress. Like, they're going to have to get weird with it. Maybe that curse is real. Maybe it's not real, but it forces Uhtred to make choices.
I mean, Uhtred needs to read The Secret and realize that that's the energy he's putting out into the world.
That's fair. My guess is that I think Stephen Bouchard has enough story equity with me for me to go along with the ride here. It was a formulaic, formulaic beginning to The Last Kingdom, to which we have already known.
Yeah, I'm bored.
I want to get somewhere where we haven't known yet. And I think leaning into that scariness with Skade is going to do that.
Okay.
I think. We'll see.
Itty Shay Skade. I could do with some like hot foreplay with her and Uhtred. Candlelight, you know, maybe he's mourning Gisolde. Odin, he's, you know, whatever. Gisela. Whatever. She's dead.
You combined Isolde and Gisela.
Exactly. He probably is too.
That's true.
At this point. Oh, yeah, the brunette. But I agree. We'll need to carry on and see what goes forward. So can we just move on from her?
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm all set.
Yeah, sure.
You know who I also am all set with? The guy that needs table manners.
Oh, Heston.
Heston.
Oh, watching him eat that meat and then Alfred just looking at him like, bro.
I wanted to vomit. So gross. I wonder how many takes it took Like, how much gross eating did he have to eat to get all those different camera angles in that shot? And they were just like, buddy, be as nasty as possible. Be a three-year-old at Thanksgiving.
Just grab a leg and go to town. Yes. I wonder how many turkey legs they had, like, just waiting for him or whatever it was, like lamb legs.
Yes.
You know, because there's a lot of people at that dinner, and there's a lot of angles that they have to cover.
I know. That's what I'm saying. He just kept eating.
Yeah. So it's like, it's not like they just do this in one take. Like, this is a big deal.
Yep.
Heston is.
He's ungrateful that Uhtred saved his life.
Absolutely. And I loved when Uhtred was like, Heston, stop talking about Ethelfled. And he's like, no more. We're done. And Heston listens. And it shows you the kind of respect, well, not respect, but the kind of fear that Uhtred has on people. And I think it is with a definite purpose that they keep talking about Uhtred being the kingmaker. He is going to be playing obviously, but
he's the lead character, so I hope he plays a big role.
good point, Mary. No, but his king-making abilities, I think, is going to have a real impact on what this season does.
Okay.
And I say that because, here, I'm going to give you an early...
Bring it on.
Oh, hold on. I got to get my sound up here because I don't have it. I don't have it, Blake. Come on.
Shame.
All right. Destined to be Theory of the Week. You ready? It's no coincidence that they show Edward training and getting his ass handed to him by Uhtred. And it's no coincidence that they keep calling Uhtred the Kingmaker. And it's no coincidence that Uhtred says to Edward, sacrifices have been made for you to live, boy. Mm-hmm. And like what that brings up, right? Like all the people that died at Ethandune, Isolde, his own child.
Possibly being like the sacrifice.
Otter the younger, Otto the older, like a lot of people died to make sure Edward was alive. My theory is that Ethelred and Ethelwald,
Prince Hans
and Drunk Kid.
Yes.
They're gonna get together here. And it's no coincidence that Ethelfled, they're showing her lead the men of Mercia. Like, they are clearly happy to be led by the Lady of Mercia.
Yes.
Like, I think she has the real loyalty of those men. Mm-hmm. So when you get all of that together, it feels like to me Ethelwald wants Edward dead. Not necessarily Alfred, because Alfred, they know he's going to croak soon. They know.
Goodbye.
It's Edward that they need dead. And Edward is going to need Uhtred.
For his protection. Okay.
And that is where all this is coming into.
So where is Heston?
Heston? See, now that's a good question too. Because, all right, let's talk about this. Bloodhair. First of all, bad nickname. Wicked bad. Can you come up with a more, like,
I probably would call him that, though, as a nickname.
I mean, yeah, but that's a joke nickname. That'd be between you and me. It's like calling Carrie Coon the Honey Badger, like, in The Leftovers.
Yeah, but he probably liked being Bloodhair.
I'm out on the name Bloodhair. That is like wearing a t-shirt at that concert.
You know what I can tell you? I remember it. I can say it. So for me, it's a win.
I'm out.
It doesn't begin with Ethel.
That's true. Good point.
So there we go. I don't need to complain about his name.
I don't like the Bloodhair nickname, but Bloodhair is going to serve a purpose. And Heston, I think, it's no coincidence that Heston says to Alfred, yeah, Bloodhair asked me to join him, and I didn't. But I think he's gonna.
Heston's on everybody's team.
That's true.
He
Heston is on whoever makes him important.
Whoever gives him dinner.
All of the lamb legs.
Yes. I'm going to go to your house on Tuesday night, your house on Thursday night.
He's like Amos Diggory, just showing up, getting some toast.
You're a wizard, Harry.
I there seems to be something building here with all of these people.
I mean, it is a season premiere, so I think you're onto something.
Loving the sarcasm today,
you're
Mary.
So wise.
Loving the sarcasm. Hey, why do you think they keep showing that hawk in front of Ethelred? You know, the thing with the blinders?
Oh, first off, let that bird outside and eat some vitamin D. Let it see. Secondly, who are you? Are you the bad guy, the captain of the Huns from Mulan? What are you going to do with this bird? Is it going to go scout things out for you? Why have a bird like that if you don't even go into battle? Get a messenger pigeon, okay? Get an owl. I don't know. I think, to me, I just saw it as, look at this prince. He has an expensive present.
Sure.
Rather than having like a frou-frou dog. I don't know if they had frou-frou dogs back then.
I'm sure they probably did.
They had like dogs that served purposes and things like that. I felt like that's a frou-frou birthday present pet.
We have the return of Aldhelm.
Is that a person or a place?
That's a person. That's Ethelred's like right-hand man.
Oh, okay.
The one with the Lloyd Christmas haircut.
Yes.
He looked like an elf from The Lord of the Rings, by the way. Did you notice that with his green, you know, elven cape? Oh, yeah.
He has a whole closet of different warrior outfits. He seems okay with the plan.
Well, you know what it is? He seems disappointed, in my opinion. He seems like he's not buying in on Ethelred right now.
Ethelred's pouting.
Ethelred's totally pouting.
And also doesn't want to die.
Aldhelm knows it, and he's like, you should be with me. Mm-hmm. You should not be in the north. There are always going to be Vikings in the north.
Where did he get grapes? Ethelfled, Red, whatever, the prince.
Ethelred, yeah.
Red.
Where does he get grapes? It's not like he's got a grapevine.
Just... It was snowing the other day.
What, did he go to Stop and Shop? It makes me wonder, is Aldhelm fully on board with Ethelred so far?
I think he's all out for himself. And if having a popular, powerful best friend helps him get to things, great.
Is that Ethelfled or Ethelred for him?
Red.
Really?
Right now, that's his bro. That's his friend. That's who's gotten him there so far.
But you can clearly see that Ethelfled is really...
He needs to walk that fine line still.
I think he's still deciding.
So I'm getting at.
Yeah, fair enough.
It is episode one.
Yeah. It's the premiere.
Yeah.
As formulaic as this was, especially with the battle and everything and blood hair taken off and whatever. I mean, the battle was gorgeously shot once again. The Last Kingdom knows how to shoot a battle.
I'm just like desensitized to things by now. I know when to cover my eyes. I know that there's not actually going to be anything important. There's going to be a look between people. And this time it was between Finnan and Uhtred.
Finnick is team Finnan and Sitric together.
Yes.
That's with Geesolt.
You know, they do a little like, oh man, close call. Thanks, bud. There's one of those each battle.
And we call that plot armor. They need to stay alive because they serve the plot.
But I don't need to watch the battles. They're gross, they're bloody, and I know that nothing major happens anymore.
Fair. That's a fair criticism.
I've seen Shield Wall a million times.
Yes.
I'm over it. Okay, it was cool the first two times.
Fair enough. That's a fair criticism as well. I will say, though, that there obviously has been a time gap in between seasons 2 and 3.
Yes.
Since Edward is now much older, I would say that there's probably been like at least a 10-year time gap, at least.
Okay.
And it's good to see that Team Uhtred has gotten even more close and even more of a team. They were actually getting some real characteristics of, especially like Sitric. Sitric has been nothing more than just like the kid with an axe, and he just does whatever Uhtred says to him.
I think he's been more than that, but I think you're right. His personality, we don't know him too well. He's a little shy fellow.
Yeah.
But he's been very loyal, and we know that he has an upbringing like Uhtred. So I don't know. I kind of feel like he's the kid in the Polar Express that gets on the train at the end, and you're all kind of like looking out for him, and then he's part of the team. You know, you don't even feel like that's the only kid that gets a name in that show, by the way, in that movie, the Polar Express. I think his name's Bobby or something.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
You don't learn anybody else's name. Who cares? Santa and Bobby. But I feel like he's Bobby from the Polar Express.
Maybe. Maybe. But there is this great scene when he's with his wife and his kid.
Yes.
And he's like, oh, finally we can go to battle. And she like whacks him a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, what? It's about time. You know, like.
But we're happy to see that he got married.
Yes,
remember we got to see him ask if he could.
They're introducing that a little bit more. We have a little bit more with Finnan, with, you know, him checking up on the raiding on the village.
How has he not settled down?
He is a hot ticket. I'll tell you that. Hot ticket, that Finnan.
Maybe there's something about him that we don't know.
That's true.
Maybe
good point.
He stinks. Like, actually smells.
Like he smells.
Yeah.
He smells like.
Terrible kisser, stinks like farts.
I'm going to go with terrible kisser. That's what I'm going to go with.
Okay. And word got around. Okay.
We're getting to know more about them and how they operate. Like, for something as simple as Finnan and Sitric tapping their weapons before they go to kill Skade's mm-hmm. guard. Like, you can tell immediately that's a thing that they do before the battle, like each battle, mm-hmm. like that's what they do. Or even Osferth. Osferth like knows his role, and you know, Uhtred goes and pushes him out and he walks up, and it's like, this is a thing that they have done. You can feel that this is a thing that they've done many times.
Mm-hmm.
And not only did they do that, they add humor into it all too. He's like, I will smite you.
Yeah.
And he's like, what is smite? He's like, oh, it's a word, isn't it? You know, like, mm-hmm. And hopefully some of you are going to run away, but you're all going to die. And then the battle happens, but something important is shown. Osferth doesn't move at all.
Why is that important?
Because it still shows you that he hasn't found his courage to fight in battle yet. Despite all this time with Team Uhtred, despite all this time with the raids and things that he's obviously been a part of, he still can't kill people.
That's okay. And I would have a tough time too.
These are things that you can gather from these small moments.
But they found his strength.
Yeah, go out there and smite people.
Yeah.
These are all just characteristics of all this stuff
mm-hmm.
That I like. Edward has bedded a woman who is loved by the guy who runs Eshingham. Twins has come out of...
Was Eshingham the place that they went
yes.
with the snow?
Yes.
Okay. So the Lady of Eshingham,
I'm not sure if it's the Lady of Eshingham. I'm not sure, but it is somebody of import.
Someone who's important.
Yes.
And she had Edward's twins.
Yes.
Okay.
And they are illegitimate.
Okay. Like Osferth.
Like Osferth. Correct.
Okay.
Do you think that this is going to play a larger role in this season, or is that just showing you a characteristic of Edward?
I took it as seeing a characteristic of Edward, because not only that, but he just is, he's just like, whatever. So what? So yeah, I slept around, and yeah, I got her pregnant. It's fine.
Hmm.
Bad character.
last thing I wanted to talk about.
Does he die historically?
Edward?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, obviously he does die. But
no, but like soon?
No.
Huh.
No. He will become king.
Okay.
I
like having these things that I can ask because it's based slightly in history.
Last thing I wanted to talk about, Mary, is the director's use of the amber base of...
The sword?
The sword. It's consistently shown. In many scenes, but as the focus of that scene. And if you go back and you look at it, there's one real specific use when Uhtred is out looking over the wall and it is the sunrise is coming up. Gorgeous shot. I mean, just like pants off kind of shot. And
I hate that phrase.
Fair enough. And instead of showing his face necessarily in the beginning, they're showing the amber base. And it's a reminder of what this is all about and why Uhtred is doing all of this. Is that because that amber, he got it from his dad. And he used to look at Bebbanburg through that amber. I really like how they are still sticking with this.
I just think of Jurassic Park every time.
Dino DNA. Anything else you want to talk about in this?
I have faith episode? That episode 2 will rank much higher. Hopefully I spent a lot less time with Skade. And Yeah, that's really where I'm at.
Do you think blood hair is going to be a big portion of this season?
No. He's basic.
He is basic. He is definitely basic.
Like, he's big. He's got good hair. It's a wig.
Yes.
He's got a lot of guys.
Got nice teeth.
Where the heck have you been, man? But then again, like you said, it's been 10 years. Yep. He's got great teeth. So he's a handsome Viking.
Maybe he grew up hearing the stories of Eric and Siegfried.
Yes, yes.
And then he finally got his own, he got his own gig.
Except he's, and this is what's tough, is it's his lover, but it's also his sorceress.
Right.
So.
And this is a thing that I think the show probably will struggle with. There has to be the new villain of the day, right? There has to be the new villain. It's like X-Files, like the bat, like the monster of the week, right? But in this case, it's bad Viking of the season. And Bloodhair falls into that mode, unless the real bad guy is not Bloodhair, but it's Ethelwald and Ethelred.
I mean, I can deal with that.
I'd like some more time with Idisfe.
What's her name?
Skade.
Skade and Arthur. I'd like him to be like, Alfred. Right, whatever. He's dying anyway. It's fine.
Yeah, you got croak.
I want some more time where he's like, all right, so since I'm dying.
Give me the 411.
Yeah. Tell me everything.
That will be an interesting relationship if that does happen. All right, okay. So are you officially calling it Skade and Uhtred? Just a little boob and butt stuff?
Yes. Little earlobe nibble, a little caress. I don't think they're going to go all the way.
All right. I am setting it up so that Skade is not butt stuff. I'm setting it up that Ethel Fled is going to be Uhtred's girl.
In this season?
By the end of the season.
That's too far.
No. All right. Fair enough. Mid-season. There's going to be something against Ethel Fled. Something bad is going to happen against Ethel Fled. And I wonder if it's going to be Ethelwald and Ethelred who make it happen. Right? So yeah. Uhtred is going to have to save Ethelfled. He is the kingmaker. There's a reason why they're showing her like being the, like the, she is now like the Sansa Stark right now of Winterfell.
Yes.
Like she's showing up and she is queen of the North.
Yeah.
Right? Queen of the North. And Uhtred is going to have to save her. In some capacity.
Agreed.
So that is my thought on that. All right, anything else?
No.
You ready to close this bad boy out?
I am.
Let's do it.
So, thank you all so much for tuning in. We're excited to delve into season 3. The first season, of course, as Blake said earlier, that Netflix has helmed of The Last Kingdom. If you don't follow us on social media, this is your friendly reminder. We're on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, TikTok, but really we most utilize Instagram and Facebook. We do have an exclusive Facebook community. Just search Mary and Blake, request to go in there. You get to hear us geek out about all the different nerddoms that we talk about or even just slightly mention here. And we cannot go without thanking our friends at jointhenerdclan.com. You have made, honestly, this show completely possible as The Last Kingdom was voted on by the members of at jointhenerdclan.com. You know, Blake and I do all these podcasts for free, and we love that we can bring a little light and joy into your lives, and we want to thank you because from the bottom and the goodness of your hearts, you are able to support this mom and pop podcast shop. If you have not yet become a member, you still can. It's totally easy. It's less than $2 a month to join. Just head on over to jointhenerdclan.com. I do want to let you know that we are going to be doing our holiday cards and our presents and stuff that we do always seasonally. We are going to be doing things a little earlier this year because shipping takes a while. So make sure that you sign up. And if you want some holiday cheer included in your patronage, just make sure you sign up for the appropriate level.
Yes. And trust me, you don't want to miss the gifts that we give because we give awesome gifts. I'm not going to lie.
We do.
I'm not going to lie. Last year it was a hand-drawn drawing. Yes. Hand-drawn drawing of the Hogwarts Express that I did personally by me.
The Jacobite, yeah.
Yeah, the Jacobite train and all that other stuff. So, you know, a lot of people loved it. It was awesome. you don't want to miss out. So we're going to cook some cool stuff up for you this year as well. And remember, we do need a new computer. So if we have a goal of 1,000 members. If we get to 1,000 members, we can get a new computer and give you all the best entertainment that you've been dying for. So, and, you know, just support a non-big company podcast company.
We're at 845 right now. Yes. So let's see if we can get to 900 by Thanksgiving. All right, friends, on that note, my name is Mary.
My name is Blake.
Destiny is all.